Hey chess lovers, welcome back to the Chessyard. This is dhairyabagga and today I'll be playing the 5-minute blitz only chess, and during the game I'll try to be as instructive as possible like always, making sure that there's something to be taken away as a learning that helps you improve your game to the next level. Now before I start with the game, I request you to subscribe to my channel and press on the bell icon so that you don't miss out on any of the videos that I'm posting up daily without a miss. So yeah, let's begin with the game and see how it goes. Got the white pieces here. I'll play the London system setup. Starts with d4. I'll get bishop on f4. Play pawn e3. These are the standard moves in the London system. And you can develop your pieces accordingly on the respective squares. Knight comes on f3. Now you can take the pawn or you can just continue developing here. So I play pawn to c3. Knight comes out. I can pin the knight is one of the ideas, but or I can just continue with my development. I'll begin with pinning the knight here. With the ideas of getting knight over to e5, pressurizing the knight further. So my opponent plays bishop here. Now I cannot go with the knight because my opponent can take. And if I then take the bishop, my opponent can take back with the knight and I lose a piece. So I have to be careful here. I can go ahead with queen over to onto c2. Bishop can come back as well, just in case. Okay, rook in front of the queen. Opponent knows the basics. I dead up the knight, connecting both of them. Opponent takes here. I can take with the knight. Or let's take the knight first. Let's see what my opponent takes back with. Takes with the bishop. Now I can take with the knight. The idea is now to attack the bishop. Maybe connect both the knights again. Rerouting my knights to better active squares. Bishop is being attacked. I can just get the bishop backwards, or I can even pin the knight here. Both the ideas work. Let's pin the knight, because if the knight comes in here over to e4, that can be problematic eventually. I cannot take because then that closes the diagonal as well for my queen to attack eventually in the long run. Open place pawn forward. So I have ideas of getting my knight here or taking the bishop. Bishop not required to be taken. I'll just go ahead with the knight. Now this attacks the pawn as well as the bishop. Plus of course the knight is pinned. So pretty good here. Opponent castles. I can take the bishop, but then queen takes, so not a great move, I would say. Let's go ahead with the knight. Trying to take all my pieces towards my opponent's king. Maybe we can go ahead with the pawns next. Okay, a couple of options here. I can continue pinning the knight or take the knight. So I'll continue pinning it, trying to make sure the pins are there for as long as possible. Opponent plays pawn forward. I can acquire d4 there with my knight. A good active square for the knight, centralizing the knights. Opponent goes back and that's why he loses the bishop. So you don't do anything much, but just try and control everything. Opponent will do some mistake or the other. That's what happens here. Tries to defend the pawn. Now, can I pressurize him further? Is the question. or do I even need to? I would say I'll come with the knight here so that if my opponent does take, I can take back. So that would be okay. And let's see what happens here. Of course, the knight is still pinned. I'm attacking a rook and a pawn. So opponent does decide to take, I'll take back. I have got a pawn there. I should be taking it, which still attacks the rook. So I'm plus four in the game. I'll go back, maybe acquire d4 again. Yeah, that doesn't bother me. In fact, what I can do here is now take the knight and rip apart the opponent's king further. Now, of course, let's come back in the center so that there's nothing being broken up from there. Ideas of castling next on the king side. More certainly I can. Opponent can is not bothering me much here. Castling is nice. Okay. Now I can go here. The ideas of rerouting and giving a check eventually. Can go ahead with the knight, attacking the pawn. Maybe then having a good fork as well eventually. So let's begin with pawn takes. And then I go with the knight. Ideas of going ahead with my knight. Now queen comes here. Trying to take the pawn next, which I don't think can be saved now because the opponent moved the king too early. And once I take, that would be mate as well. Takes, and that's checkmate. Yeah, that was internet disconnection, so that's my delay in Lee just showing that it's checkmate. So I hope you liked the video. It was pretty much easy way that I played this game. Nothing complex there. I just tried to make sure that the pin is maintained for as long as possible. Irritating my opponent with the pin. And opponent lost it there with losing the bishop. Just trying to develop my pieces normally here. And once my opponent takes the center pawn, I can take with the center pawn, of course, and then castle queen side. But I decided to take the knight first. After my opponent takes, I take with the knight. Opponent offers bishop for exchange, which I deny and maintain a pin. Then go ahead with the knight over to f5. Opponent castles. I go with knight f3. Opponent tries to kick my bishop away. I maintain the pin. Didn't take the knight there. Opponent plays pawn forward. I just centralize my other knight. And my opponent makes a mistake, trying to remove my knight from there. I take on the bishop, and then trying to exchange light square bishop with the knight, and successfully doing it, attacking the rook here and the pawn. Opponent goes back, trying to save the rook. I take a pawn, then come back. Queen comes in, but then I just take on the knight first so that my opponent's king is ripped apart open. Then go ahead with the knight back to d4, trying to control the center. With the knight, then castle king side, then go ahead with queen e2. Knight comes, I take on the pawn first, and then go ahead with knight to f5. And then opponent moves king here instead of placing his pawn forward or maybe the rook away so that he has an escape square for the king. So that's mate in 3, and that's what happens. Okay, that was mate in 1 as well. But then I went ahead with the plan which I had thought earlier. So that was completely solid and precise in the moves as well. I hope you like the video. Do let me know your feedback. Keep watching and sharing. Do subscribe to the channel if you haven't already by now. And I shall see you tomorrow with another game of mine. Thank you so much for your time. Take care. Bye-bye.